This is the continuation part of the plant life. Today we are going to study about the venation. What is venation is? The pattern or arrangement of the veins and veinlets in a leaf blade or a lamina is called as a venation. What is the venation here? The pattern or the arrangement of the veins and the veinlets where the midrib has branches out into form the veins and veins which again branches out to form and many veinlets. Okay, in a leaf blade. So the pattern of these, the arrangement, we call it as a venation. And the venation is of the two types. That is, the first one is an reticulate venation and second one is an parallel venation. What is reticulate venation? The veins and veinlets are interconnected and form a network on leaf blade, and this type of venation is seen in most dicotyledons plants. You can see the picture here, and this is the midrib and midrib which is branches into veins, the veins which again branches into veinlets, and totally which forms like a network like, and this type of venation we call it as a reticulate venation. And this type of reticulate venation you can see in the most of the dicotyledon plants. What are the example of reticulate venation? The example is an oak tree, rose and mango. Next type of venation is parallel venation. Here you can see in the picture the midrib, which is the center part of the leaf portion. Here this vein which runs parallelly to each other and are connected laterally by minute straight veinlets. And this type of venation you can see in the grasses. And this type of venation you can see in most of the monocotyledons plants, not in the dicotyledons. Dicotyledons, you can see the reticulate venation, whereas the parallel venation you can see only in a monocotyledons plants. The examples are the banana, wheat, lily plant and the various grasses. Let's study now what is this function of the leaves, whereas in the last video we covered the different parts of the leaves. So what are the functions of these leaves are? The first point is leaves which prepare the food for the plant by the process we call it as a photosynthesis, by using in sunlight, chlorophyll, water, air and the many minerals. And food is manufactured in the form of a glucose and oxygen is given out. What is the role of the oxygen? Whereas an oxygen which supports the life on earth. And the small, I told, the small tiny pores which are present in the leaf, that is on the lower surface, that we call it as a stomata. What is the function of the stomata? The stomata helps in exchanges of gases like carbon dioxide and oxygen. And this pores which helps in the transpiration process. That is, the transpiration process is nothing but to release the extra water from the surface of the leaf in the form of the water vapor. That process we call it as a transpiration process. Next, the modification of the leaves. In some plants, leaves are modified to form special functions. You can look at the picture here. It is not looking like leaf, but here this is the modification of the leaf. This is the one type of the leaf only, but it is not similar to like your leaf. This is a different modification. What this modification we call it as? This one we call it as a tendrils. Why these tendrils are there? For the support. Let's study about this one. In some plants, the leaves are modified into thin coiled thread-like structure called it as a tendrils. Look at here. Isn't it looking like coil-like? Yeah, and it is also looking like thread. Okay, why this is there? Because the tendrils can be seen in the plants with a weak stem and the tendrils which helps to support. This is the one functions of the tendril type of the leaves which gives the support to the plant. And this type of the leaves you can see in the pea plant. And next modification is the spines. Okay, why these spines are there? To give the protection. Leaves of some plants are modified into sharp pointed needle like structure called spines. You can see in the picture. Okay, the sharp spines are present on the leaf surface. Okay, what is the function of this one? Whereas The spines, which reduce the loss of water from leaves and also protect the plant from grazing animal. And where you can see this type of spines, leaves, which are present in the desert areas only. Why these are present in the desert area? Whereas the spines' main function is to reduce the lot of water from leaves and also protect the plant from grazing animals. The examples are, that is, cacti, Optimia. These are all the example for spines type of leaves. And next is the scale leaves. In some of the plants where the leaves has been modified into scales like, there is example in a ginger, and whereas here it is the thin and dry and also which protects the axillary bird. And also in the onions also, here the scale leaves of the onion are thick and fleshy. You can see the lines here. That is, we call it as a scales, but here the scales is not dried. Here the scales are very thick and it is a fleshy. What is the role of the scale leaves? Whereas they helps to store food and water for the plant. And next modification. Whereas the next modification is leaf modification in insectivorous plants. Before that, let's study about what is an insectivorous plant means. The leaves of some plants are modified to trap the insect to obtain food. Such plants are called insectivorous plants. These plants grow in the soil that are deficient in one or more nutrients. Where we all of you got to know that, whereas in the soil many types of the minerals are present and nutrients are present. But whereas if any one nutrient is deficient, okay, that time, whereas and your these type of the leaves are present in that. What is the role of this one? The leaves has been modified to trap and digest the insect. And the examples of the insectivorous plants are pitcher fly and Venus flytrap. Let's study the first example of the pitcher plant. In a pitcher plant, the leaf blade is modified as a pitcher. Look at the picture here. Okay, and the apex or the tip of the leaf is modified into lid of the pitcher. You can see in the picture where I am showing. This is the body of the pitcher. Here the leaf has been modified like in pitcher like, and whereas in the tip, that is an apex part of the leaf has been modified like in lid like. As the insect sits on the rim of the pitcher, it slips and gets trapped inside. If any of the insects come and sit here, automatically the lid will close, so the insect will get trapped inside the pitcher plant. And next, what will happen? The digestive juices release inside the pitcher and get digested the insects. Okay, understood. And next example we are given for the insectivorous plant is Venus flytrap. What will happen in a Venus flytrap? In Venus flytrap, the lamina is divided into two parts and the midrib acts as a hinge. You can see the midrib here. Okay, this is the center part of the leaf, that we call it as a midrib. And here the lamina is divided into two parts and midrib, which acts as a hinge. And each part of the lamina has a several hair-like. Here you can see in the edge of the leaf where the small hair-like structures are present, that we call it as a trigger. And when the insect sits on the leaf and touch the air, the leaf snaps shut and the insect gets trapped inside. And as like in our pitcher plant, how the digestive enzymes will release, same in the Venus flytraps also, when the insect gets trapped, that time the digestive enzymes will be released and it will digest the insect. And next one, the vegetative propagation through leaves. What is the vegetative propagation means? The vegetative propagation is a method of asexual reproduction in plants. And here, the new plants develop from the vegetative parts of the plant, such as leaves, stems, roots. The example is an bryophyllum. The bryophyllum develops small birds called adventitious birds on their margins. These birds, when fall on soil in favorable condition, it form a new plant. And this is the one type of an asexual reproduction in the plants. So here what will happen, and here the tip of the leaves where the adventitious root will arise, and whenever it fall on the soil, if it gets a suitable favorable condition, that time it started to form a new plant. In this video, we covered the topic about the venation and the functions of the leaf. And next one, the different modification of the leaf, that is a tendril, the spines, scale leaves. And next, we cover the topic of leaf modification in insectivorous plants, that is a pitcher plant and the Venus flytrap. And last topic we covered is vegetative propagation through leaves. Thank you.